Hi, I'm Donovan with another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Ralph. We're going to talk about container native developer experience powered by open source tools from Microsoft. Welcome to the show, Ralph.
Well, thank you very much.
So what do you do here at Microsoft?
I'm a program manager for the open source developer tooling experience. That actually includes several tools. We'll talk about a bunch of them. But the idea is to create an environment in which, for any container development environment, whether you're going to build applications that land in Kubernetes, for example, especially that, you need a series of tools that help you get from application development to containment, or a Docker file, things like this, if you're familiar with that. And from containment, you need to do service composition in order to align all the containers in the appropriate ways so that you can install them as a logical unit in Kubernetes and get things running. In a Windows environment, that's usually something like Visual Studio or something larger, right? More coherent. In the open source world, those are Linux tools, and Linux tooling culture has a sort of different approach to it. They tend to put things together in individual ways so that you can create a tool chain.
You can replace
and remove one or the other tools very easily. And we've built a bunch of those tools that work wonderfully for this experience. It works in any Kubernetes cluster, whether it's locally or if you're using the managed Kubernetes service in Azure.
Perfect. So we have a lot to talk about. So this is just the first of actually three videos that we're going to shoot together. Mm-hmm. And what we're going to do now is kind of lay the foundation and talk about how all those tools you just described kind of work together. And then in the other episodes, we're going to drill into Draft and Brigade and explain how those actually work. So given that, why don't you go ahead and kind of lay the foundation for this talk for us?
Sure. So microservices, we would call that, used to call that SOA, service-oriented applications, architecture, and so forth. Microservice approach applications are now moving toward from native development. So if you actually write your application, you actually ship your application code itself. It's not contained in a Docker container, for example. We've perfected tools for that, but in fact, containment is an amazing way to increase your agility, increase your consistency. DevOps become potentially much, much more agile and powerful. But you need a tooling environment for all that because containers are a different tool to use, right?
Absolutely.
So you're going to need other things. So to move from native development to container native development, we need something that helps people write Docker files correctly or acquire the correct one for their application. And we need something that will understand how to take those containers and deploy them coherently in Kubernetes. Those tools already exist, and Microsoft is a major either contributor or creator of these tools that we offer to anybody in any Kubernetes cluster anywhere.
Okay, that's good to know because I'm a developer for 20 years, and when I got introduced to containers, I just had this complete fear over me of all these new things I had to learn, and how do I go from doing the development that I know and love to putting it inside of a container? And it sounds like the tooling that we're going to talk about in this series are the tools that I would need to start to use to be able to bridge that gap and hopefully hide a lot of that complexity away from me so that I focus on what I'm good at, which is developing software, and all the container magic just sounds like it's going to happen for me.
Yeah, it mostly does. Of course, all these tools you become an expert in, but not everybody can become an expert in every part of those
tools.
And you really want your developers, or at least the majority of them, focusing on writing code.
Absolutely.
So the thing about Docker containers, for example, a Docker file, if you've seen it, and many people have now, or they're tinkering with it right now, it's a pretty simple file format, but I was just at DockerCon in Copenhagen recently, and I found people walking up and they really didn't know that many configuration commands in a Docker file. And that's at DockerCon. And what you realize is that most developers really still do native development, okay? And then when they think their app is working, they'll go Google or Bingle, as we say, some Docker file that is similar to what they think they're doing, and they'll try it. And it may work and it may not, but then they have to delve into something that is not development.
Sure.
They're just trying to debug containment.
Gotcha.
And they haven't even figured out how to do service composition and deployment yet.
Gotcha.
Because that's a different format.
Gotcha.
So, and so we want to remove those steps from the main body of developer experience.
So what tools are those?
We have several tools. The most important one is packaging things is the second one. It's Helm over here. And that I use that first because that one is the default accepted package manager for services, logical entities that are a bunch of containers working together to form one application into Kubernetes.
Okay.
So you do Kubernetes install and point at what is called a Helm chart.
Okay.
Which is a simplified form of a Kubernetes manifest. It's much easier to understand and use.
Gotcha.
And you can do all kinds of developer operations there with that tool against the Kubernetes cluster. So upgrades, deletions, you know, different kinds of releases, canary updates, and so forth.
Gotcha.
This kind of thing. So that's Helm. And it's very much like apt-get or NuGet if you're in there, or chocolatey kind of thing.
Gotcha.
So it's very sort of metaphorically easy to understand.
Okay.
Right? But then there's the developer environment too.
Yes.
And so we need to help developers acquire the proper Docker file for their application type.
Sure.
And we also need them to acquire the proper Helm chart so that their application container can be easily installed.
Okay.
Right?
Follow you.
And we don't want the developer spending a ton of time doing that. They make mistakes, but even when they don't make mistakes, they take time, and it's not development.
Right.
Right? The tool for this is Draft, which is the first one up here.
Okay.
Right? And then finally, once you built that application, you need to actually deliver it.
Right.
Draft just helps you test it in containers and deploy it as fast as possible. For Microsoft people, it's like the F5 experience. Instead of F5 creating a debug version that's running natively, F5 will actually create your container with your application in it and deploy it with a Helm chart so that you can see it running instantly, already contained, already functioning in Kubernetes.
Great. So I'm a Visual Studio baby for a long time, right? So it sounds like
you should be.
Working here, I should be,
yep.
Right? But what's interesting is what Draft sounds like to me is the right-click add Docker support inside Visual Studio for the open source world.
Almost exactly like that.
Got it.
Absolutely.
Okay, great. Because that connects the dots for those of us who are coming from the Windows world. So we have Helm that helps hide the complexity of building a configuration for Kubernetes.
Mm-hmm.
We have Draft that takes the native developer and turns them into a containerized developer by building out all the scaffolding that I need to break my Docker file, be able to build the image, and be able to deploy the image where I can actually see that, yes, it's been containerized and it actually functions the way it's supposed to.
Exactly.
Right, and then at that point, as a developer, I have all the artifacts now that I can commit to source control,
mm-hmm.
and I would assume at some point, all those artifacts now have to be packaged and then deployed into my cluster.
Yep, you're going to trick me here, but that's going to happen with GitHub, right? And you're going to do a git push, or in VSTS, a git push to the git repo, right? And you're going to trigger off some kind of CI/CD
Absolutely.
System, continuous integration, continuous deployment. We have a tool for that in the open source world. Many people will be using either a free service, CircleCI, TeamCity, this kind of thing, or VSTS,
yep.
or some other service.
Jenkins,
right?
Anything
Jenkins
like
they
sure.
set up. The thing about Jenkins is it's a wonderful open source tool. A lot of people know it, and there's tons of sort of built-in experience in,
sure.
in files and things like this. But Brigade is the tool that we built to do this kind of work, not just for CI/CD, but for any structured containerized pipeline. And that's a little bit funky, but let's start by talking about it with CI/CD as an example.
Okay.
So a Brigade pipeline, Brigade is a service that you can install with Helm in one line in any cluster. So it can install locally here in Minikube, or you can install it in AKS or any other place. You know, if you have a bare metal cluster and Raspberry Pis, you can install it there too and use that.
Got it.
Right? So what you do with Brigade is you give it a project, which is really a JavaScript file, in which every function listens for a certain event, and you can use JavaScript to call any number of functions in any order you wish, whether they want to be run as parallel jobs or whether they should be in series, right?
Sure.
Okay. Each function is actually created in Kubernetes as a container and executed inside a container.
Got it.
Using shared storage so that you can pass state from one container job to the next. In a way, it's basically like scripting using pipes on a bash shell.
Got it.
And
so you're basically
Linux
just
mounting
drives and
yes,
those
absolutely.
Images. Got
it. And you can mount other kinds of storage, but those details we'll talk about later.
Yeah, absolutely. So interesting. So now it looks like we now have this nice set of tooling that we can use to take a developer who was new to containers and get them all the way from, I have no idea what containers are, I don't even know how to create a Docker file, I'll use Draft for that, I'll be able to then use Helm to figure out what my Kubernetes configuration file needs to look like, and then I'll be able to use Brigade to get that code actually out into my cluster.
Or test it first, build the images, stash
perfect.
Them in perfect place, digitally sign them. All of the normal CI/CD workflows that you would associate with any automation pipeline.
Now, if I'm not mistaken, these are all open source tools that we contributed to the open source.
Yeah.
Where can someone go and like, where are the repos they need to go look at? How could someone go and contribute and look at this?
It's pretty easy. First of all, the Helm was originally developed by the current team at Microsoft. Microsoft that we acquired when we purchased Deis.
Got it.
Last spring. And so they're my development team. And so Helm is the package manager for Kubernetes by de facto usage. You can go to Helm SH and start from there. And of course, you can just click through to the docs or go straight to the GitHub repo, and you'll find all the things you need to know either to use it or to contribute to it.
Perfect.
Right? Brigade, we talked about. Brigade is the event-driven scripting for Kubernetes. That's the automation service you can use for CI/CD or anything else.
Okay.
And we'll show you about that. And there's also another project that goes with Brigade. It's called Kashti, which we just released, which is a lovely web UI that allows you to use as a dashboard or reporting system for all your Brigade pipelines.
And then Draft is also open source, and there we go.
And there's Draft, and that's the developer container native iteration tool.
It
helps you set up all those files to start with and, you know, get your application on the right path to container native development instead of you having to figure it out yourself or any number of other developers.
And I always joke that this is not your daddy's Microsoft, and to see this many open source projects actually championed and started by Microsoft is incredible. And another thing that I noticed, which is really interesting, is you're on a Surface Book, but that is not Windows that you're running behind us.
No, it isn't.
So you spend the majority of your time in a Linux environment
I have a Mac, of course, because we have to, you know, make sure that everything runs on all the operating systems, not just the Linux, but Mac, but also Windows. So these tools are available for Windows users as well. But I do all of my corporate work on Linux on my Surface Book because that's just a great machine.
No, I agreed. And it was funny because I always tell people the first time I ever installed Linux was actually after I joined Microsoft, is such a strange thing to tell people that I joined Microsoft
weird.
And then I installed Linux for the first time.
If you follow me on Twitter pretty much every week, it's getting less and more and more rare that it happens, but pretty much I do mention that hell has frozen over again. It does. It's a running joke that works.
Fantastic. Well, I'm really looking forward to the other episodes where we'll be able to dive deeper into Draft and into Brigade. But today we're learning all about containerized developer experience powered by open source tools from Microsoft here on Azure Friday.